So while we was talking about this, the real life examples. So JP Morgan, if you heard, they are big in a banking as well as the investment, one of the biggest company on this financial side. So they used one AI-based platform for all the contract intelligence, AI-based. That means they have to scan all the contract before signing off. And usually the human being, they can only read 1,000 pages in a day in their working day, while this AI based their what they built for the contract, so that they can scan, which can read out, which can perform based on their training data, and more than a 36,000 pages was done in a 1 working hours. So it's they multiply the work with the help of AI. Same the IBM Watson, it's for the medical diagnostic. So they used to have more than the 10,000 million articles available on the internet. They use the perform the diagnostic based on this all the articles, based on the report of any human being, and they can detect and diagnose the disease, and it was getting help in the multiple things. So they all are the live demo examples where the AI is helping in our life. So now on the AI, if we talk about the next topic, what is the ML, right? So machine learning, have you ever heard about the machine learning? So what is your view on this machine learning? Any of you?
Yeah, sir. Can I?
Yes, sure.
Sir, actually, machine learning is the part. So, which the, for example, I'm just saying. So we can just have it on a collections of data. So in the collections of data, so we wanted to train the data. So instead of using the trained data, so we are giving another one part. So it will be working. Something what I'm trying to say is, so for example, we are just collecting 100 peoples of data. So in the 100 peoples of data, so we are just giving to a machine. So the machine will predict, so what is this, what is this, what is this actually. That is the thing in my knowledge I just have it on.
That's correct.
So something it should be like a prediction. So it may right, it may wrong, depends on our training, depends on the what are the input we are giving, so it will be giving the output. Yeah, sir, hello.
Yep, that's correct.
Yeah, thank you.
Any other view?
Sir, I think taking machine to a level where machine can learn with its experiences and already made decisions, earlier made decisions on its own, is machine learning.
That's correct. That is also the right definition.
So when machines are trained, algorithms and instructions are given to them, and they are to learn from their past experiences also. That is
That's
machine
correct,
learning.
ma'am.
Sir, I think Quick Draw by Google is an example of machine learning. Is it so?
Yes, Google is also using machine learning.
Quick Draw app which Google has.
Quick Draw. No, ma'am, I did not check, but the Google is using a machine learning in a very in a big time, like. Okay, so let me tell you about this machine learning, right? So this is again part of the AI, right? If we talk about the AI only, right? Let's say this is the AI. So the machine learning is the another division of AI, right? So what is the machine learning basically, right? It's a basically a data analysis process, right? So if we go with this definition wise, So it's a data analysis process, which usually the machine automates based on the data, make a predictions, make all the analysis and give us an output, and which help us in the decision making. And sometimes machine will make a decision based on this data analysis and all. And this is known as the machine learning. And when someone said about the minimum intervention, that is also correct. There was a type of machine learning. When we talk about this, the supervised machine learning, unsupervised machine learning, right? There was a technique. So the supervised where we required some of the interventions, the unsupervised where the interventions are not required. So if we talk about the ML, like the process point, so the Gopi, I believe, right? Gopinath ji, right? So when he brief about that was the correct, the data will be given and there was a training to be given to the machine. We will talk about this in a detail, and the based on the model, we will talk about this also in a detail, and the decision has been made, right? So in a very simple language, if you ask me to brief, right? Jab hum machine ko koi sa ek data dete hain, us data ko analysis karke machine को हम बताते कि इस डेटा में क्या देखना है और क्या नहीं देखना है, राइट? दैट वाज द ट्रेनिंग पार्ट, जो हमने डेटा दिया है उसको इनपुट, एंड इट्स डेटा इज अ वेरी ह्यूज डेटा व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द एमएल डेटा. सो दैट मींस कि वो फाइल जो है वो 2-4 10 GB की फाइल हो सकती है, या 2-4 10 TB की फाइल हो सकती है, राइट? दैट मींस अ ह्यूज डेटा. वी कैन गिव द डेटा व्हिच वी कैन नॉट एनालाइज एज अ ह्यूमन बीइंग इन अ शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द टाइम, राइट? सो वो डेटा हमने दिया, उसके ऊपर उसको ट्रेन करा. जो ट्रेन करना है, दैट मींस कि उस डेटा में क्या देखना है, कौन से वेरिएबल्स उसे देखने हैं, राइट? सो वो ट्रेनिंग के लिए हम एक सैंपल डेटा उसको बताते हैं कि जस्ट फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर मैं किसी मशीन को डिफरेंशिएट करवाना चाह रहा हूँ, या किसी मशीन के ऊपर मैं एक एल्गोरिथम रन करना चाह रहा हूँ कि बारिश होगी तो मैं बाहर घूमने नहीं जाऊंगा, बारिश नहीं होगी तो मैं बाहर घूमने जाऊंगा. लेट्स से दिस इज द वेरी सिंपल प्रोसेस. अब यही चीज उसको देखनी है अक्रॉस वर्ल्ड में, लाइक 7 billion पीपल्स के ऊपर, कि हाउ मेनी पीपल्स विल बी गो आउटसाइड ड्यूरिंग द रेन एंड हाउ मेनी पीपल विल नॉट गो आउटसाइड ड्यूरिंग द रेन, राइट? सो मैंने ये ट्रेनिंग डेटा उसको दिया है सिंपल, कि ये एक ह्यूमन टेंडेंसी है. अब बारिश के साथ में मेरे पास में अगर कार है तो मैं घूमने जाऊंगा, मेरे पास में बाइक है तो मैं घूमने नहीं जाऊंगा. लेट्स से ये सेकेंड पैरामीटर दिया, राइट? द थर्ड पैरामीटर, If someone who is the married, वो बाहर घूमने नहीं जाएगा भले कार हो तब भी. Someone who is unmarried with the car, he can go outside, right? So इस तरह के मैंने उसे parameters दिए, and I asked a machine to perform this task on the 7 billion data, that's in all the population, right? So उस population के ऊपर निकाल के कितने percent लोग हैं जो बारिश में इस conditions को fulfill करके घूमने जाएंगे, right? So वो easily उसको recognize करके मुझे एक डिसीजन बता देगा कि लेट्स से आउट ऑफ 7 billion पीपल, 23% विल बी गो आउटसाइड ड्यूरिंग द रेन एंड दे आर आल्सो हैविंग अ कार. 12% पीपल हु कैन गो आउटसाइड ड्यूरिंग द रेन एंड दे आर हैविंग अ टू व्हीलर, राइट? सो बेसिस ऑन दिस, ये जो मैंने उसको डेटा दिया था, ये मैंने ट्रेनिंग डेटा दिया था, ये सारे कंडीशन के ऊपर उसे जो बताया था. सो दैट मीन्स मैं मशीन को ट्रेन कर रहा था, एंड देन बेसिस ऑन द ट्रेन उसने अपना मॉडल सेट करा. उसने मॉडल कहाँ सेट करा? उसने ये सारी कंडीशंस खुद लगा के देखा है कि अच्छा अच्छा ये सारी कंडीशंस होती है, ट्रू है, दैट मींस दैट कैंडिडेट विल बी पास माय टेस्ट, दैट मींस ही विल गो आउटसाइड ड्यूरिंग द रेन, और रियली कंडीशंस बनती है सो वो नहीं जाएगा, राइट? सो लेट्स से यहाँ पे ये जो दो कंडीशंस बनाई है, दैट मींस कि मशीन ने ये दो मॉडल्स सेट कर दिए, और इस मॉडल्स के बेसिस पे उसने सारा डेटा देखा है, एंड देन ही विल गिव यू आउटपुट. And basis on this output, we can make a decision. Let's say I want to sell some particular product. So I got to know कि ये 12% people है जिसके ऊपर मैं target कर सकता हूँ. मुझे अगर मैं कोई sales के लिए ये prediction निकाल रहा था, मुझे कुछ different statistics के लिए prediction निकालना था. Let's say कि related to some of other statistics, तो मैं ये data के basis पे उसके ऊपर decision ले सकता हूँ या statistics बना सकता हूँ. So you can sense like it's a huge data of a 7 billion people on which this ML has been run to, and which helped me to made my decision accurately, correctly, or close to the perfection. So this ML is clear to everyone? Any doubt on the ML?
No sir.
No sir.
Right. So ML में जो एल्गोरिथम्स वाला पार्ट है दैट वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द लेटर स्लाइड्स व्हेन इट विल बिकम राइट. सो बिफोर गोइंग अब लेट्स सी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द कन्वेंशनल प्रोग्रामिंग एंड द मशीन लर्निंग राइट. सो हाउ द कन्वेंशनल प्रोग्रामिंग हैज बीन डन राइट. ड्यूरिंग अ ट्रेडिशनल प्रोग्रामिंग हमें आउटपुट पता होता है कि लेट्स से मैं बहुत ही सिंपल सा एग्जाम्पल ले रहा हूँ राइट कि मुझे कोई सी एक एल्गोरिथम रन करनी है या फिर वो एल्गोरिथम जो है वो बेस्ड ऑन दी पाइथागोरस थ्योरम है राइट. सो पाइथागोरस थ्योरम है तो मुझे उसके आउटपुट्स पता है कि ये आउटपुट्स आने चाहिए. सो उस आउटपुट्स को ध्यान में रखते हुए मैं एक प्रोग्राम राइट करता हूँ. ड्यूरिंग ऑल द ट्रेडिशनल प्रोग्रामिंग अगर आप में से किसी ने प्रोग्रामिंग का एक्सपीरियंस है या इफ यू ऑल ऑफ द गाइज आर ट्राइंग ऑन द हैविंग अ हैंड्स ऑन ऑन द प्रोग्रामिंग. सो आपने अभी तक जो भी प्रोग्राम्स लिखे होंगे या जो भी आपने पढ़ाए भी होंगे तो उसके अंदर आपको हर एक प्रोग्राम का आउटपुट पहले से ही पता था कि हमें ये डिजायर्ड आउटपुट चाहिए. उस आउटपुट को ध्यान में रखते हुए आपने प्रोग्राम जो बनाया था कि आपको इनपुट क्या आ रहा है एंड आउटपुट क्या होना है राइट. व्हाइल इन दिस मशीन लर्निंग राइट बेसिकली हम क्या करते हैं कि मुझे इनपुट पता होता है कि ये इनपुट है राइट कि ये इनपुट है. इस इनपुट के ऊपर मुझे ये ट्रेन करना है जो मॉडल मैंने बनाया हुआ है जो मॉडल की हम बात कर रहे थे या ट्रेनिंग डेटा है वो ट्रेनिंग डेटा मैं दूंगा एंड आउटपुट मुझे नहीं पता है वो इस बेसिस पे जो भी आउटपुट लाएगा वो मुझे देगा राइट. सो जब मैं उसको इनपुट देता हूँ और मुझे जो आउटपुट मिल रहा हो रहा है राइट वो बेसिस ऑन दिस इनपुट जो मैंने ट्रेनिंग डेटा दिया है जो मॉडल सेट करा हुआ है उसके अकॉर्डिंग मुझे आउटपुट मिल जाता है. सो दिस इज द बिग डिफरेंस बिटवीन द ट्रेडिशनल प्रोग्रामिंग एंड द अप्रोच बाय द मशीन लर्निंग व्हाट वी यूज्ड टू हैव. सो एनी डाउट ऑन दिस.
नो सर.
एक्सक्यूज मी सर. सो दिस ट्रेडिशनल प्रोग्रामिंग इज नॉट द पार्ट ऑफ एआई.
ट्रेडिशनल प्रोग्रामिंग इज नॉट द पार्ट ऑफ एआई बट यू कैन यूज मतलब व्हाट आई मीन टू से द ट्रेडिशनल प्रोग्रामिंग जब हम बनाते थे लेट्स से हमने कोई भी प्रोग्राम बनाया है तो हमें आउटपुट डिजायर्ड पता होता था कि हमें आउटपुट क्या चाहिए. हम उस आउटपुट को ध्यान में रख के प्रोग्राम रखते थे जबकि मशीन लर्निंग में जो डेटा आया हुआ है जो हुज डेटा हम डाल रहे हैं तो हमें आउटपुट नहीं पता है वो आउटपुट हमें मशीन देगी. सो हम यहाँ पे सिर्फ प्रोग्राम बनाते हैं इनपुट एंड प्रोग्राम and output comes on the basis of this.
Sir, which language do we use to make program while working with machine learning?
Ma'am, there was multiple languages can be used, even the Java, but the most famous is a Python. And the reason why the Python is so famous, reason being ki Python jo hai na, wo badi simple, one of the most simplest language. So, wo likhne mein bhi simple hai, samajhne mein bhi simple hai, एंड उसके पास में बड़ी स्ट्रॉन्ग लाइब्रेरीज है राइट. सो दैट लाइब्रेरीज हेल्प अ बिग टाइम. देयर वाज मल्टीपल लाइब्रेरीज ऑफ द पाइथन व्हिच आर स्पेशली डिजाइन्ड फॉर द एआई प्रोग्राम्स ओनली.
ओके सर.
सो आप वो लाइब्रेरीज को कॉल करना है आपको ज्यादा एल्गोरिथम्स लिखने भी नहीं. एल्गोरिथम प्री डिफाइंड है आपको सिर्फ उसकी वैल्यूज कॉल करनी है. सो दिस पाइथन इज द वन मींस आई कैन से इफ यू आस्क द एआई बेस्ड प्रोग्राम तो 99.99% पीपल यूज द पाइथन for this AI.
Okay. Sir, like if a person is not from a computer background, so roughly like in how much time you feel the Python can be learned?
7 days maximum. Okay. For the Python, you can become the intermediate. And yeah. The basis on the uses of the Python, probably you can be expert in a month's time or the basis on the uses and your practices, right?
Of course, yeah.
So it's a quite simple language. And last time also we given the Python training to the during the advanced session. So that was the basic Python. Like the plan was from a basic to intermediate. So we captured 90 minutes time only to deliver that Python. What we prepared the program.
Okay. So thank you.
So up. आप अगर शुरू करते हैं तो विद इन 7 days यू विल बी लाइक प्रो इन द पाइथन. एंड जस्ट फॉर द मोटिवेशनल आई कैन गिव यू एग्जांपल ऑफ माय सन जस्ट फॉर द मोटिवेशनल राइट. लास्ट ईयर ड्यूरिंग दिस पैंडेमिक माय 8-year-old सन आई टीच हिम अ पाइथन एंड नाउ आई कैन टेल लाइक ही इज मोर एफिशिएंट देन मी इन द पाइथन.
good.
We can back up games also in a Python now.
Oh.
Which probably I'm not sure I can prepare as fast as he's doing. So it's quite a simple language. Anyone can learn Python. The only syntax for any language is required, only the grammar. If you know the grammar correctly, probably your language will be close to perfect. The same is the syntax and the method.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, instead of Python, we can use any block codings. Na? There is a many block codings or the open sources platform. Something we can use block coding for this also, no?
With the block coding, you have some of the certain limitations. Let's say if I want to draw the chart on the basis of the data input, what you given, like you briefed me about this ML, right? Okay, you given some ML data.
I'm saying for the basics, the learners. So you can
for the basic learning. Basic learning block coding is also okay. Look, the block coding, Python, they are all of the same.
That is the thing.
Yes, so yes.
They can know in English now, they can just know the yes or no conditions. They can easily create a block coding in just 1 or 2 days. They can easily learn. That is the thing.
Yes, yes, yes. Look, block coding are perfectly good. Means, in my view, any 7 year plus in the age, we should teach the block coding to them, because that help in the decision making as well as, and they are so simple and so helping to, you know, the nourish this child brain also. So block codings are the one of the perfect, like the scratches, and there was a multiple block coding, right, which can be used even with this your Arduino. You can use the block coding also. But to learn on the syntax, you should go with this, you know, CLI-based programming. Then only you come to know what mistakes you are doing. Even a single dot can make your program hold for the hours to analyze if you are not able to identify where the dot has been making a problem. Nowadays, we are having a very good compiler. Even a very old time when we was having a C, you know, the Turbo C++ or the Turbo C, if you learn or if you see the old programming. So वहाँ पे जब हम compiler run करते थे, so वो error दे देता था, and वो error किस line में वो नहीं पता होता था. So we have to relook every syntax again to identify कि कहाँ पे वो गलती से dot भी लग गया है तो. But nowadays with the Python and all, you usually got this so much good compilers or the programming platform, they give you the line wise view, so you can easily identify it ki wo kahan par hai. But the CLI base is I will recommend in this age you can go with the CLI base. This is just my personal view, right, so that you can learn more about the syntax and all, which is pretty much required when you want to write a big program. Let's say any of the script more than a 10,000 lines you supposed to write down, so that will help you in the for the future scripting part. So back to the topic, any question related to this, we can move ahead, right? So this is one of the example, right, we discussed during this, the banking sectors, the telecommunication sector, they are using this ML based platform to identify their users. Ma'am, your voice is cracking. Ma'am, you have to mute. Okay, so we was talking about this, the banking sector, telecommunication sectors, they are using the ML-based algorithms to identify ki the user who will be actually a late payers, and so there was a late payment model was implemented by them. So what they have all the demographic bills, and as a output they got this the paid late or not, and on the basis of that they make the programs previously. Nowadays they make a change with respect to the further parameters related to the uses and all, and they can make a model where they can identify the person who's actually will pay the late, so that they can start triggering on a time. on the basis of the historical of data, on the basis of the uses of the data, or the uses of the credit card, uses of your phone bills. Nowadays there's no phone bills. We are having almost all the things are same price, right? So, but this kind of models were used by the telecommunication as well as the banking sectors. So now back on this topic of the AI, how this machine learning is connected with the related with the AI, right? So we can say this artificial intelligence subset is a machine learning, right? Where all the decision making or the all this data related work or the predictions or the data analysis part has been taken care by the machine learning. And there was another part is the deep learning, right? So deep learning is exactly the mimic of human brain. We will discuss this deep learning maybe tomorrow during or the next session, right? More in detail. So there was a three part of the AI. One, the AI, right? Where we are having a certain rule. Then there was a machine learning where we are having the two different mode. Is one is the self-learning or the supervised or the unsupervised mode, and then we are having a deep learning, which is a neuro-based the learning algorithms where machine learn and evolve himself and give us the output. So this all are connected with the under the one umbrella of the AI, what we can call it, right?
Excuse me, so sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Like here we are showing that the a part of AI is machine learning. So the remaining part of AI is what? Like whole of the AI is not making any machine to learn?
No.
So what that part if
you
to?
Yes, if you remember during one of the answer I said about the weak AI or the artificial narrow intelligence. You remember
we speak about this.
So there was a certain things, right? There was when we said on the AI. So first let me brief you about the machine learning first, right? So what is machine learning till now what we learn? Jo machine learning hai wo basically kya kar raha hai ki wo sari algorithm base khud learn kar raha hai एंड आपको वो मॉडल्स दे रहा है विच इज रिलेटेड टू सम प्रिडिक्शन, डेटा के ऊपर काम कर रहा है. सो सारे एआई प्लेटफॉर्म जो है वो डेटा के ऊपर काम नहीं करते हैं. आपका जो एलेक्सा है वो डेटा के ऊपर काम नहीं करता है, वो कोई प्रिडिक्शन बना के नहीं दे रहा है, वो एज अ लर्निंग मोड वो डेटा ले रहा है, राइट? वो एनएलपी बेस है जो आपका नेचुरल लैंग्वेज को समझ के उसका आउटपुट आपको दे रहा है, राइट? दैट मीन्स एलेक्सा सीरी एनएलपी बेस, राइट? They are just collecting and they are giving you output. They are not doing any database prediction or something. So wherever we required an analysis of the data and some of the decision or the prediction or the output in form of the data is actually a machine learning. So that's why the machine learning, this AI portion, what is not shown as the covered or even not the machine learning is shown under the AI also. Because the machine learning something beyond the AI also. When I said beyond the AI, that means is there was a multiple things where we required only the hard coded data and the hard coded output where the intelligence is not required. That is run by the machine also. That is also part of the machine learning with the bare minimum AI features, what we can say.
So in a scratch way, what is that hard coded things required? The device, the designing of the device.
Yes, I can say that designing of the device or the output is fixed.
Jo
question tha ki output mera fix hai, right? और मैं डेटा के साथ में प्ले करना चाह रहा हूँ. मैंने एक डेटा दिया इनपुट एंड आउटपुट. आई नो कि मुझे ये डिजायर्ड आउटपुट ही चाहिए. And basis on the data, वो desired output दे रहा है. So that is my hard coded कि मुझे यही output चाहिए. I don't want that machine to do any of the prediction or any of other analysis than the my desired output. So जब भी मैं एक desired set goal को वही output देखना चाह रहा हूँ और वही output मुझे चाहिए, उसके beyond मैं उसको process नहीं करने देना चाहता हूँ. That is usually be called the hard coded इट्स इट नॉट रिलेटेड विद द मशीन में ही या फिर वो सिस्टम में ही हार्ड कोडेड कोड डाल दिया है. दैट इज ऑल्सो वी यूज टू कॉल हार्ड कोडेड वेन वी सेड. बट इन द लॉजिकल लैंग्वेज द हार्ड कोडेड समथिंग रिलेटेड विद द फिक्स आउटपुट वॉट वी रिक्वायर्ड एंड वी डोंट वॉन्ट मशीन टू लर्न और एनालिसिस बियॉन्ड दी अवर डिजायर्ड आउटपुट.
Yes.
So let me brief you, like I just tell you about the one part of this artificial intelligence, which is the narrow intelligence, right? The VKI. There was the second part of the artificial intelligence, which is the general intelligence, artificial general intelligence, right? So this general intelligence is something where, you know, the machine learns and they perform the ability to do the task like the human being. Some of the robots, you learn about the Sophia or some of the robots, they are actually the second generation, what we can say about the second grade of the AI, which is the artificial general intelligence, right? Or the, if you heard about the machines which learn the playing by looking, by observing the human being, and they start playing the games or something, right? There was a number of examples when the robot learn and then they start playing. So they are the second generation, which they are going beyond the certain task, and the limitations is now they are having a more wide open area for the learning. And the third generation, what usually the people call, is a super intelligence. And the super intelligence is something which is not there nowadays. It's like something the machine will take over the human beings, what they called. That means artificial super intelligence, the ASI.
Be possible, like every time we go about this AI, so like this thing is always in mind. So if the machines are going to overpower human, so why we are working that much for it? Like sometimes even the students, they may ask this thing.
Like, yes, ma'am. But trust, like these machines, this language, this algorithm is prepared by the human.
Yeah.
So for sure, so they will. Yes, yes, ma'am.
Sir, I actually, I would want to answer this because I read it somewhere that the only thing that humans and machines, AI machines, lack is empathy. So the thing which has to be ethical, the hacking hoti hai aur ethical hacking will have to, in speaking of empathy in our children, so that they don't use AI and worsen the situation.
You are absolutely right also, and thus maybe on a day three of this training we will talk more about this also, because there was a topic what we called the ethical AI or the ethics with the AI. So there was a certain monitoring measurement for the AI programmings also. So
we will teach ethics to a machine, like, because it has a capacity to learn itself. So now when it is learning itself, so how it will learn ethics, like we can't be sure about it, you know, like maybe a doubt.
No, you are correct, but just to get this answer, I will suggest you one of the web series on this Hotstar.
Okay,
I forget the name. I watch eventually, like the graphic best designing word.
Best word.
It's a Indian this one, like the all the graphic designing is done by one of my friends, so who sent me a link, like Pranav, if you like. So Pranav is the graphical designer for that web series. So usne mujhe link bheja tha ki ye dekhna hai, to mujhe initially to bada boring sa laga tha, to be very frank. I will tell you when it is start, but that is completely based on the ethical AI concept. That web series is, it's shown the India on the future when these machines is taking over every task of the human being.
Yeah,
right. And there was a rule for the machines, and which is actually the ethics of AI, and it was coded in every machines to follow the ethics.
Okay.
So you can, like, that's the world imagination by some of the writer, but that's quite close to the things. And
so we just can't believe that the machines will have the good generation only, like not with any of the evil qualities in them. They won't turn it to.
That's only happened in Arnold ka movie mein hota hai, ma'am. Wo bas aur baki kahin nahi hoga.
Right, sir. Nice.
I will search name and I will suggest, like, इनिशियली फर्स्ट जो उसका पहला एपिसोड है दैट वाज अ लिटिल बिट बोरिंग, बट उसके बाद में धीरे धीरे जब वो बिल्डअप होता है ना, सो यू कैन कनेक्ट वंस आफ्टर अवर थ्री डेज ट्रेनिंग, जो हम इथिक्स एआई वाला टॉपिक कवर करेंगे ना, देन यू कैन वॉच आफ्टर दैट, देन यू कैन कनेक्ट दैट टॉपिक विद दैट सीरीज.
राइट सर, थैंक यू.
सुशील सॉरी आई कट यू इन बिटवीन.
So there was one movie also of Rajinikanth. He prepared one robot, and he that means army people were want to implement that robot in this. So that was a beautiful example of AI.
Yes, yes, that robot movie itself, right? Itself, that was also a good example, right?
So that means the ethics. They what the madam was asking about the ethics. So that means that robot was discarded just because it was not having a feeling. So when that robot is getting an order to fire and all that, but he could not able to distinguish between that, whether to be fired and not to be fired, whether the person is our person or a different enemy people. Such type of ethics is that?
Look, ethics is related to the programming. When we are writing a program, so it certain follow the rules, and when it will be come on the next, like what we are talking about, the super next generation, right? Or we are talking about the super intelligence, the which also called the ASI, right? So artificial super intelligence. So that artificial super intelligence, probably there will be some ethics. जैसे हमें law follow करना होता है कि like red light is the law breaker, so we have to stop at the red light. So similar kind of things will be encoded in the systems when we are designing such a system which can build a super intelligence, so that they can follow the basics since the day one. What are the rules they have to follow? What are the things beyond their control? So such a things can be incorporated, and I'm sure that the developer will be taking care of these things. As I said, these all are created by the humans, so they might be there. They for sure they will take care of such a things.
So just one last thing for this category, like if we are in the general intelligence right now, like our machines are thinking like human. So like at which stage we are, like. Till like if we talk about a normal human brain, so like machines are being designed to think like humans, say to 60% to 80%, like, because if we know answer to this question, then we will be able to judge by when we will be reaching in the super intelligence stage.
I can say if you ask the human, they are just the 2% or a 5%, I can say. Okay. Not beyond the 2% or 5%. Right. Human brain is something the miracles things can be done by the human brain, and what we are building, we are just building with respect to just to help our job,
right sir.
Nothing beyond that. So it's just 1% or 2% of the task is getting performed by the AI nowadays. It's not more than that.
Thank you, sir.